Ripple, for the crypto lovers, that might be an interesting opportunity. Of course, this is a short-term trade here. We're not talking about investments, guys. What I'm looking for to do here is buys. Okay. Now, starting from the daily chart, let's go through everything. First of all, this hidden divergence is not reliable since we are inside this range here. Okay. But it's still some sort of bullish pressure that this pair XRP USD is starting to show. Second of all, we got false break here on the top coming with this divergence, which is a good reading now that we're starting to get invalidation of this bearish pressure, right? This is what basically it's giving me from the daily chart. Another thing we can get from here is the levels. Okay, looking back, this is mid-2018 here. You can see that it's basically 1 year period. We have a fantastic zone, and that's all 36, 35, all 38 zone, right? Basically, whatever was marked here in this zone. So now dropping down to the lower time frames, we know that as long as this low is holding here, okay, that entire zone, we could be looking for possible buys. All right. This is where the 4 hour chart divergence started forming. This is where we started seeing false breaks. And this is where we would be expecting for the price to reverse. Now, since we have all this room to the downside, to this bottom here, right? 36, 35, it's best for us to go ahead and look for conservative entries. That would mean we want to see the most recent high, okay, valid high for us to be broken. In this case, I would be going with this one, right? This is the 4122, at least my broker here. So at that stage, that would be the conservative entry breakout above it. Of course, the better situation here would be to see no breakout above, to see one more push lower, okay, coming as closer as possible to that low, and then to get the breakout of a newly formed high, okay, and enjoy the move up. And of course, invalidation would be if the price breaks below these levels, confirms that breakout, we can stop looking for the buys. Okay, in terms of targets, I would be focusing on the risk reward ratio here, which means if we get lower and my risk reward ratio is tiny, I can immediately close some profits around the middle of the zone. We have plenty of good levels, and this level is one such place. Okay, later on we have this one. Then right here, I think you get the point, right? So find yourself some good level. Of course, watch out for divergences to form against you. And if that happens, time to cash out, or at least push the stop loss to break even. All right. Final target around the top. And by the top, I mean this zone right there. So that's pretty much all. Maybe last thing we want to mention here is that since we got the false break, we can now go ahead and remove that and this one just for a second. And since that false break appeared, guys, now we have second false break that could be easily seen as a horizontal range, right? And this is exactly why I'm marking this zone and not just the trend line here, okay? Because if you're trading the shrinking pattern, then you have false break on top, possible false break on bottom, and you're wondering what's happening. And exactly because of that, we should stay ahead and consider that as a horizontal range, which has all the reasons to become one based on the most recent price action. So that would be all. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to join us in the Telegram group.